Welcome to St. John the Evangelist, the oldest and most vibrant Catholic community in Baltimore County, Maryland. On behalf of Father Pete Littoral, our pastor, and the entire parish staff, we want you to know that you are welcome, loved, and prayed for. The COVID-19 pandemic has affected all of us. At this time, please take a moment to pray for all those who have died from this deadly virus.
Good morning.
Good morning
and welcome to the 33rd Sunday of Ordinary Time and our Veteran Appreciation Mass. Our celebrant for this liturgy will be Father Coughlin. Please stand for our national anthem, and please remain standing for our opening hymn to follow. May be found in your Choose Christ Missal on page 442 for the beauty.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Bob.
We welcome today all the veterans, the Catholic veterans, and our auxiliary as we remember our veterans for defending our country and our Constitution at this Mass this morning. Before we begin, let us pray our Synod prayer. The card can be found in your pews. We stand before you, Holy Spirit,
as we gather in your name, with you alone to guide us. Make yourself a home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path. Nor partiality influence our actions. Let us find in you our unity, so that we may journey together within the life and not stray from the way of truth and what is right. All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you, especially the veterans of foreign wars, who served our country and defended our freedom, and all those representing every branch of our services who are present today. In this celebration, we will be reminded by the Word of God that it is not easy to live as Christian in today's world. The sacrifices of our veterans offer us reality of the pain and suffering associated with doing what is good and right and just. This reality may be discouraging, but the promises of Christ give us great hope. Our call now is to focus on the promise of God's kingdom. So recalling God's mercy and forgiveness in Jesus, let us open our hearts to the Lord. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
For it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
At this time, I invite the children to come forward who will be participating in our children's liturgy of the word.
There's three nurses there right now. Children, come forward. We're good.
Like to carry the book this
Thank
way.
You.
Good
send you forward to listen attentively to God's word, and we anxiously await your return. But in the meantime, may God bless you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. In those days, I, Daniel, heard this word of the Lord. At the time there shall arise Michael, a great prince, guardian of your people. It should be a time unsurpassed in distress since nations began until that time. At that time, your people shall escape, everyone who is found written in the book. Many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake. Some shall live forever. Others will be in an everlasting honor and horror and disgrace. But the wise shall shine brightly, like the splendor of the firmament. And those who lead the many to justice shall be like the stars forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, you will show me the path of life, you my hope and my shelter. In your presence is endless joy, at your side is my home forever. Taken from Psalm 16 and found on page 23 in your Blue Gather hymnal, page 2-3.
My heritage, you my wisdom and my safety. Through the night you speak within my heart, silently you teach me.
Shall sing for joy.
Brothers and sisters, every priest stands daily at his ministry, offering frequently those same sacrifices that can never take away sins. But this one offered sacrifice for sins and took his seat forever at the right hand of God. Now he waits until his enemies are made his footstool. For by one offering, he has made perfect forever those who are being consecrated. Where there is forgiveness of these, there is no longer an offering for sin. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to his disciples, "In those days after that tribulation, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from the sky, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. And then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the end of the earth to the end of the sky. Learn a lesson from the fig tree. When its branch becomes tender and sprouts leaves, you know that summer is near. In the same way, when you see these things happening, know that he is near at the gates. Amen, I say to you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But of that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Start looking at the second coming of Jesus. And this is a theme that continues during the first half of the Advent season, because Advent is not just preparation for Christmas, but a preparation for the end of time. And the first reading and the gospel reading have this end time orientation.
Both readings present the end time as potentially unpleasant experiences. The first reading says, "It shall be a time of unsurpassed distress." And Jesus says, "In those days after that tribulation, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from the sky, and the powers of heaven will be shaken." The tribulation mentioned in the gospel reading is a reference to the destruction of the temple, followed by a whole series of trials. We are living in that time of tribulation. The temple was destroyed in 70 AD by the Romans when they put down an uprising of the Jewish people. But not all in these readings is doom and gloom. The reading from Daniel is the earliest mention of belief in the resurrection of the dead. Many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake. Some shall live forever. Jesus tells the disciples to learn the lesson from the fig tree. When its branch becomes tender and sprouts leaves, you know that summer is near. In other words, the tribulation is a sign that the Son of Man is near. This means we should not be afraid. Instead, we should have hope. We believe in a God who brings life from death. The second reading reminds us that Jesus has offered the one sacrifice for our sins. Our sins are forgiven. Setbacks should not stop us from persevering. Tough times should not cause us to question our faith in God. They should instead inspire us to draw closer to God with confidence, to put more faith in God, since heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Reflect on what Jesus just said there. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. The things we think of most as being permanent are in fact ephemeral. The sun is halfway through its lifetime of 10 billion years. When the sun begins to die, it will become a red giant and expand, most likely consuming the earth. And yet we think of the earth as being permanent. In contrast, the words of Jesus will still be true and will not pass away. This way of thinking may seem strange to some of us, but what is the goal and purpose of our lives? Is it to accumulate the most stuff? Is it to live forever on earth? Or is it to spend eternity with God in heaven? If we wish to spend eternity with God in heaven, we have to follow God and allow him to teach us how to love like his Son. This does not involve accumulating the most stuff. This does not involve trying to live forever here on earth or being recognized as the most powerful or the most important. This does not involve moving from one pleasure to the next. It is allowing God to teach us what is most important in life, to love God and to love our neighbor. All our stuff and all of ourselves should be devoted to this love. We should be living our lives for the good of the other. And that's one reason, again, why we were commemorating our veterans this morning. They were living their lives for us. If we are living according to the eternal words of Jesus, is there a reason to be afraid when Jesus Christ comes again? If we are living according to his words, wouldn't we instead be welcoming him as a long-lost friend? But of that day or hour, no one knows. Either the angels in heaven or the Son, but only the Father. Jesus speaks these words concerning the end of time, but they also apply to us as individuals, because we do not know the day or the hour of our own death. But we need to be prepared. As the assigned gospel acclamation for today puts it, be vigilant at all times, and pray that you have the strength to stand before the Son of Man.
Please stand.
I believe in one God, the Father,
the Almighty, maker of
heaven and earth, of all
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Let us now ask our Heavenly Father to listen to our prayers and to look down upon our brothers and sisters in arms and bless them as they stand ready to defend our nation. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
For our church leaders, Pope, Bishop, priests, and deacons, especially those who have served in the armed forces of America, that they may remain strong and resolute in their missionary work of the church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear.
For all veterans of the Army, Navy, Air Force, and Marines, that they may receive the blessings of comfort and encouragement, that they may know not that they are forgotten, either by you or by their loved ones at home, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who experience the darkness of war, those who have returned sick and wounded, that may God place his healing hand upon their body and spirit and steady them against their battle against depression, trauma, and all forms of disorder, we pray to the Lord. For all families of veterans, that they may be blessed for the hardships that they face, the sacrifices they made, and for the many contributions of America's freedom and democracy, we praise to the Lord. For all veterans who have died, and for Bethany Policiano, wife of Jamie Policiano, may God continue to bless them in heaven and grant them his love, mercy, peace, and eternal life, we pray to the Lord. For Ann Heisner, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now pray our bicentennial prayer. Again, the card can be found in your pew. Son of God, we are grateful for you. You have sent your Spirit upon this community of St. John the Evangelist, who accompanied one another and accounted in her love and peace for 200 years.
Jesus, we turn to you and look for your guidance, so that we may work together as a community to support the mission of St. John the Evangelist along Green Valley,
to love God, love others, proclaim the good news, and make disciples for at least 200 more years. Ever faithful are your works, O Lord. We are truly blessed and encouraged to continue to serve you and your people. Amen.
Please be seated.
Our offertory hymn may be found on page 764 in your People's Mass Book. That's your brown hymnal, America the Beautiful, page 764.
Just
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands with the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the cause of his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty, we may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you, and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from an unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end, we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you felt us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, William, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy.
with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you all. Peace, Father.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Those who are not with us in person this morning, you can now join us in communion by making an act of spiritual communion.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already here, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen.
Our communion hymn may be found on page 267 in your Choose Christ Missal, Bread for the World, page 267.
Bread for the world, a world.
In honor of all of our veterans, those men and women who have so graciously and endearingly served to protect our freedoms, our liberties, we present in respect, God bless the USA. If tomorrow all the things were gone I've worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife,
I'd thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom
and they can't take that away. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me. And I proudly stand up next to you and defend us dear today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Texas, from sea to shining sea,
from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time to stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know.
And check our parish website to learn more information about the activities, ministries, and spiritual offerings taking place at our parish. You're all invited to join our community fellowship at the social hall for our coffee and donuts after this Mass. The Knights of Columbus are doing a sign-up for their blood drive. They just moved their table out to the patio. Work on the handicapped entrance and parking for the physically challenged has been completed. There's parking and an automatically opening door into the social hall from where you can access our new elevator. Upcoming bicentennial events, the bicentennial book. Let your family's pictures and greetings be included in the bicentennial commemorative book. Information is at the table in the narthex. Advent wreath lighting. We invite families, friends, or groups to light the Advent wreath at the beginning of each Mass during Advent. There is a sign-up sheet in the narthex, or you may call the office. The Advent giving tree. See the bulletins for details regarding the changes this year as we partner with the Franciscan Center. Hats and mitten tree. Bring your donations to the narthex on December 18th and 19th. Creche and Christmas tree lighting, blessing of the Bambinelli. Let us build community and the joyful spirit of Christmas on December 4th as we light up our campus and bless the creche. Then join us in the social hall for cookies, cocoa, camaraderie, and carols. Come in red and green. The Christmas cash raffle. You should have received your tickets in the mail this past week for a chance to win one of our cash prizes. Please support this cash raffle for our parish. Call the office if you want more tickets. Quiet Center. Part of our Advent season prayer and musical. On December 12th, after the 11:30 Mass, there will be a musical presentation of the Quiet Center. A light lunch will be served after Mass. We want to thank you for your support to the ministry and operation of St. John the Evangelist Church through your weekly offering, via online, or envelopes. Your volunteering and weekly donations enable us to continue providing good worship experiences, live streaming, and pastoral care programs. We now have a special blessing for all our veterans, so we ask you now to please, the veterans, to please stand up for this special blessing. O loving and peaceful God, we ask for blessings of all those who have served our country in the armed forces. We ask for healing for the veterans who have been wounded in body and soul in conflicts around the globe. We pray especially for the young men and women who have come home from the battleground with injured bodies and traumatized spirits. Bring solace to them, O Lord, that we pray for them when they cannot pray. Have mercy on all our veterans who have served abroad. Bring peace to their hearts and peace to the regions they fought in. Bless all the soldiers who served in non-combative posts. May their calling to serve continue in their lives in many positive ways. Give us all here, present today, create a vision to see a world that, growing weary with fighting, moves to affirming the life of every human being and so moves beyond war. We thank you for their gifts of service and ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please stand. There's always one Marine. Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth and charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please remain standing in place until the presider's presence has completely exited the narthex. Our closing hymn may be found on page 431 in your Choose Christ Missal, Holy, 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 page 431.